How's it going? So, Monday, I went out and had supper at a restaurant and saw a movie with a friend. And then Tuesday, as usual, I went bowling. So, both nights, people asked me to join Clan Wars, I guess it was, when I wasn't there at all. You know what I mean? I was outside my house even, you know? So anyways, yeah. Just thought I'd mention that. Yeah, Tuesday I go bowling. I belong to a league. So far, they're upset when I'm not there. Oh man, I bowled under a freaking 100, man. Last night. Oh, that's not good, by the way. We've got one woman on the team that's what I will call, or who I will call, a serious bowler. But my playing is just off the wall. Not consistent, to say the least. And when I try to aim, it resulted last night in a gutter ball even, you know? I was like, what the f— I didn't say that, but you know what I mean. Oh well. That sounds funny. Well, if you care about your roll of tank rating, I can't recommend this, but there's some tanks that I
We've
used to
fixed the
hate
truck. We've fixed the
because they were
truck. Get
usually
going.
long and drawn out, boring. So I decided to find places to go right away that either result in sudden death or fantastic amounts of spotting damage, etc. Are you, what tier are you playing? Actually trying to be top by damage caused on my team, and there's a tier 3. And I usually get it, but not today, of course. Funny. Actually, sometimes I'll get behind or to the side of especially like a heavy tank, and start firing at them, and they don't realize that I'm right behind them or beside them, eh? But that's very rare. Rare. I've had it happen to me where I've realized, oh shit, there was actually a guy, you know, shooting at me, and it's usually when I've been concentrating on particular No, it's funny, I'm not even familiar with that clan. No, like Relic and Arms D. If it was Cracked you were talking about, I know them, for example. Bacon and Eggs, that's interesting. Cool name. Are you still working? How's that going? I don't know what's normal there, but normal to me would be if you honestly think that you've had COVID or have COVID, probably then you shouldn't go back to work. But that's just my opinion, right?
C'est parti.
Right. I understand. The thing is that from a moral and viable position, if you honestly believe that you have COVID and then you go into work, if you're going to be honest, which I highly don't recommend at that point, then you better start becoming a pretty good liar, because otherwise you're liable, you know what I mean? And also, people aren't going to necessarily respect you if you make them sick with COVID, you know what I mean? So you knew that, or sorry, you thought, but you were very sure that you had COVID. Yet you still came into work, and now my parents are dead because of you. Yeah, thank you. No problem. I have a large contempt to my workplace. Oh. Because they just were, I don't know, very nasty people, a lot of them, man. I'm happy that I was able to go on long-term disability, because otherwise I'd be in deep shit now. Well, it's nothing I ever fucking wanted to use, I can tell you that much. If you'd told me before I had even the first near-deadly accident, resulting in serious injury and being fired, if you'd told me I was gonna be doing nothing for the next 10 years, I'd be like, you're full of shit. I'd be like, I run my own corporation. I work full time, 10-hour shifts, up to 6 days a week on top of that. I could see myself cutting back, but not working, period, anymore. But I was a danger to myself and others by the time I finally... I was physically and mentally fucked up by the time I actually stopped working completely. I actually shouldn't have been working when I still was working, doing what I was doing, operating equipment and driving large trucks. I couldn't sleep for 4 days at a time. If you can't sleep for 4 days at a time and you're not on drugs and your job includes carrying a gun and driving at high speed in a car, I suggest you stop working. You know what I mean? Well, I was, I guess you could say, lucky that I had and still have doctors that are willing to say, this guy is, I'm not gonna sign off on this guy being still all right. You know what I mean? From a moral and a liable and a professional way. But the last psychiatrist I went to was actually I'm not kidding you, he's a professor of psychiatry at the University of Toronto. The University of Toronto in Canada is like the university that you need the highest marks to get into, and they have all the funding in the world, so they can hire who they want to. This guy is a fucking lunatic, and he was the last psychiatrist that I had. He was in charge of my prescriptions for like mental health drugs, and the last time I was in his office, he said, don't come back. And he didn't say, and this is how you can get your prescription medication or carry on with it or whatever. You know what could happen if a person is on prescription medication and they don't continue for mental health reasons? You can be in fucking jail, for example, because you went fucking ballistic. You know what I'm saying? Like, that guy is not, I don't know what the guy's problem was, man. And here he's supposed to be the one teaching the future psychiatrists, and this is his behavior? Give me a fucking break, man. By the way, is this being streamed? Because I kind of hope not. Oops, maybe I should have kept my big mouth shut. But shout out to that psychiatrist. Yeah. Well, that's why I go out in the garage with my air gun and I shoot targets just to remind me that I can actually consistently shoot a target. Whereas in this game, you don't know what's gonna happen. Like, it might take you 5 shots just to actually hit where you actually aimed, but eventually, you know, in the game, you're gonna hit something, right? Unless you get blown to shit in the process, that is. Is it just you and me in the room? Oh yeah. Did you hear what happened with Charles Rollins, Yana? I'm sure that there's two sides to this story, but essentially he sent messages in chat to fellow chat taxi members and told them to go fuck themselves in writing. Needless to say, he was kicked from Yes. But then he's also a member of TAC S. So so Canuck, private PUD chat band, Charles Rollins Nimiana banned him from TeamSpeak. So, so today Canuck reinstated Charles Rollins Nimiana's ability to be on TeamSpeak because it's still a member of TAC-S, and TAC-S is your domain, not Canucks, not anybody else's. So I'm just giving you a heads up. There's two sides to every story. I have no idea what set off, what's his name, Charles, but Hotel announced that he had sent a long, as he put it, message to Demiana offering that if he apologized and they sorted out what the problem was, that he possibly come back to taxi. But Nimiana, Charles Rollins, hasn't responded, so. But there is, I'm sure, because I heard from another person, another side to it as well. And I don't know the whole story, but what it sounded like is that taxi was playing TAC-S and asked Charles Rollins to give away the tactics of TAC-S to TAC-C members. I think that's what I heard. I'm totally not gonna stand behind that. I think that's what I heard, but I could be totally wrong. But it was MacGyver and Charles talking, right? And MacGyver was saying that he congratulated and applauded Charles for not giving up his tech stuff. If that's the case, then if you find that out, then you should tell Canuck what happened, because then it changes the things, doesn't it? So that's a, see, I'm not making this up. You know what I mean? There's something to this. Okay. See, I'm not making this up, man. What exactly happened, though, I do not know. But that's what I heard. And I don't know if they knew I was there or not. But at least I've given you the heads up, you know what I mean? So it sounds like lots of fun ahead for you to sort this out. That's, what type of, are you using stunning ammunition? Oh, yeah, the leaf blower doesn't do stun. What is it, a tier 7 or something already that you're hitting? I don't know, man. It is. Like I said, man, that's why I go out in my garage and shoot some shots at a target. Just to remind me that I can actually shoot shit in real life, you know what I mean? I find that I notice how bad the dispersion, or whatever you want to call it, is. I notice it even more in artillery more than other types of tanks. Like, you aim somewhere and you can see your shell land, and it's not where you aimed, you know what I'm saying? Like, So if the same thing is going on with your other types of tanks too, so yeah, for all you kids out there, that's what's gonna happen if you smoke marijuana. And your throat too. Oh man, I stopped to aim for a shot, an enemy, and I pulled his ship. Alright. Well, that sounds like fun. Woohoo. Well, you tell him, in your opinion, it seems like you've got COVID and don't want to be responsible for other people. You tell him, well, you try to hand the responsibility on to the next person. Good luck, but it can be done. Not once, but at least twice, I was given a type of truck that had a lot of problems. And one of the problems was things on the engine would blow off and all of the cooling fluid would leak out. Yeah, so at least twice I was on the side of the road with one of these trucks and they told me to drive from where I was to yard, and I explained to them that the engine no longer had any coolant, and one time the asshole tried to suspend me for not following orders and driving the truck with no coolant to the yard, including probably he went on a highway. And I went to the big boss, his office, and I said, this guy told me to drive this truck, and I told him that all the coolant was on the side of the road. And I said, who would be responsible if I knowingly drove according to orders, if the engine seized, and I knew full well that the engine was going to seize, because I had, as I reported, it had no coolant. I said, who's going to be responsible for like the engine seizing, which will cost thousands of dollars to replace, you know? So I wasn't suspended. But, you know, like, if you tell them you really think, honestly, you've got COVID and you've gone for the test and the whole works, they say, you at work, then I think you've done your due diligence. The other thing is you could put it in writing and send it in an email. That way it's in writing and it's nonverbal. You know what I mean? As they say, put it in writing. Make a record. actually the saying is if it's a religious person, get it in writing. You've heard that one before, right? All they care about.
Броня не пробита. Повреждение гусеницы. Шанс разрыва увеличен. Пробитие. Танк уничтожен.
I'm actually agnostic. Can I say that word in this room while we're streaming? Yes. I need to get 6,000 hit points in a battle. Not really close, but I was at 4,645. That's close to 5,000 again. Three kills. Demiana, he's the one that has the wife with cancer, I think, too, right? So who knows what's... Oh, no. Hey, man, today my mission, my final mission is be the top player on your team by damage caused. In the last mission, I was the second from the top. By damage caused. The guy, I had a total of 4,645, and the guy that was top had 4,736. So 100 approximately difference, man. Just one shot difference. Oh, man. Kind of funny. That was in my Bat Chatillion. That's a good tank, eh? You don't have it? Do you have the charfouture? Oh man, if you've got the charfouture, you can switch the same crew in and out of the BC-25T, man. They work well together for crew training and all that, you know? For your COVID test? Yeah, COVID is still alive and well, isn't it?